What's up? It's MrElones.com coming at you with information on FHA loans and why they are so popular. Now, the reason for the popularity is high loan limits, lower home prices, and lower down payment requirements have made these government-insured loans a more secure bet for homeowners. As a result, more homes now qualify for FHA loans, and you can now purchase higher-priced homes using an FHA loan than in past years. However, things may be changing. There are great incentives right now to buy homes, and there are proposals out there to change the FHA loan program to require increased down payments, higher credit scores, and more expensive FHA insurance premiums. So, here are just a few things to know about an FHA loan today. Number one, you should go to an FHA-approved lender or broker. Number two, you can expect a low down payment. An FHA loan requires only 3.5% down, and you can get that payment as a gift. So what that means is that a friend, a family member, or a relative, or an employer can help you out with the down payment. Now, this is huge because in conventional loans, this is not a possibility. Number three, because FHA insures your mortgage, lenders may be willing to give borrowers loan terms that make it easier to qualify. According to HUD, in a 19-month period from January of 2008 to August of 2009, the average credit score for an FHA-insured mortgage loan increased from 621 to 692, meaning that you would need to have some better credit in order to get a loan. For conforming loans, which are conventionals, credit scores in that range will require a 20% to 30% down payment. Now, it's up to the underwriter to determine what's an acceptable credit score, meaning that it can vary from bank to bank. Number four, first-time home buyers have some advantages. A huge thing is that they can have a non-occupant co-borrower. So, what this means for a kid that just finished college and has a normal credit, a parent can co-sign on the loan. Then once the kid is in a better financial shape, he or she can assume the loan without having to refinance for a higher rate. So this is a major benefit for any young adult that's looking to purchase their very first home. Number five, sellers can contribute closing costs. Sellers can pay up to 6% of the purchase price. So if you have a $100,000 home, they can pay $6,000 towards your closing cost. Number six, there's help in finding the FHA loan limits. FHA loan limits, the max amount a borrower can borrow, varies based on a variety of housing types, the state and county in which the property is located. In order to determine what the FHA loan limits are in your area, you would need to visit the HUD website, which is HUD, H-U-D. Some counties have loan limits below $300,000, while others have limits higher than $729,000, which is a major plus for people that live in New York, San Diego, California. Number seven, for FHA approval, you will need to document your income extremely well. FHA does have some rules that are tougher than a conventional loan. For example, in order to get approved for an FHA loan, you must account for every penny of your income that comes in. Now, Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac's qualifying debt-to-income ratio is approximately 28% to 36%. This means that your mortgage payment, which is your taxes, insurance, principal and interest, and homeowner's insurance, cannot exceed 36% of what your gross monthly income is. Now, FHA's back-end ratio or starting ratio is 31 to 43%. Now, what this means is that all of your current debt obligations, including the new mortgage payment, cannot exceed 43% of your gross monthly income. They will also want to document any income to prove that you have a stable source before they're going to approve you for the loan. For moderate income buyers who can't afford a large down payment, an FHA insured loan can be a viable option. So FHA has 7 great benefits that we just went over when purchasing a home or refinancing. So if you have any additional questions, be sure to visit MrElones.com for more information.